Good morning, students. You have to take out your History and Civics book, class 7th. Yesterday, we have started with the new lesson of Civics, lesson number 1, the Constitution of India. The topics to be discussed in this lesson are number 1, its introduction, number 2, meaning of Constitution, number 3, making of our Constitution, number 4, the role of Constituent Assembly, number 5, framing of the Constitution, number 6, adoption of the Constitution, number 7, the preamble to the Constitution, number 8, basic elements of the preamble, number 9, objectives of the Constitution. Yesterday, we have done its introduction and meaning of Constitution. Today, we will start with the making of our Constitution. Before reading, we will discuss the mind map of making of our Constitution. Here we have the mind map of making of our Constitution. From here, we will start. India. We all know, India got independence in 1947. Before that, Britishers were ruling over India. The rules and the regulations formed by the Britishers were followed by Indians. But after 1947, the Indians followed the rules and the regulations written in their own constitution. But it was not an instant action. In 1934, M. N. Roy, a pioneer of the communist movement, proposed an idea of constituent assembly, but it was rejected by the Britishers. Then, again after 1 year, in 1935, Indian National Congress demanded for the constituent assembly from the Britishers, but again they rejected their proposal. Again, in 1939, Gandhiji wrote in his writing that they will frame their constituent assembly, who will write the constitution, the rules and the regulations for the Indians. Then, finally in 1946, with the coming of cabinet mission plan, the constituent assembly was constituted. Now here word comes cabinet. It means most important ministers in the government who have regular meetings with the prime minister. What is this cabinet mission plan? According to this plan, it contains the proposal regarding the constitutional future of India. Students, you have to revise these dates again, as these dates are important for your competitive exams, for civil services exams and the entrance exams in the future. So you have to revise these dates again. Students, you have to take out page number 128. Making of our Constitution. When India gained independence from the British in 1947, it was urgent to lay down the rules and regulations that would govern our independent nation. Independent means free nation. An urgent need for the Constituent Assembly was felt for the purpose of considering and adopting a constitution for our country. As Gandhiji wrote in 1939, the Constituent Assembly alone can produce a constitution indigenous to the country and fully and truly represent the will of the people. Indigenous means originating the characteristics of the country. Gandhiji in 1939 wrote that the Constituent Assembly only can give the regional characteristics of the country, and only the Constituent Assembly can truly and fully represent the will of the people. The role of Constituent Assembly. Now new word comes Constituent Assembly. Let's discuss the definition of Constituent Assembly. Group of elected representatives which is assembled for the purpose of drafting or adopting a constitution. It means the group of representatives are assembled together. Why they are assembled? For the purpose of drafting or adopting a constitution. A word comes drafting. It means to make first copy of the writing or raw writing before it becomes the rule. The people from the different political parties and the communities and the regions of India became the members of Constituent Assembly. Here we have the map of India. in this map, we can see two colors, pink color and the yellow color. Pink color here indicates the princely states, जहाँ राजाओं का राज था. And the yellow color in this map shows the rule of Britishers, where Britishers were ruling. And the people from the different regions of the India, from the different communities and from the different political parties became the member of Constituent Assembly. The total members of Constituent Assembly were 389, out of which 208 were from Indian National Congress. Number 2, 73 were from All Indian Muslim League, 15 were from others, and 93 were from princely states. This calculation was before the partition of India, but after the partition of the India and Pakistan, the total number of members in the Constituent Assembly were 299. Our Constituent Assembly consisted of members belonging to the different political parties, communities and the regions of India. Consisted means includes. It fully represents the states and the provinces of India. Provinces, the states where there were British rule. It was given the power to abrogate or alter any law made by the British Parliament that was applied to Indians. Abrogate means cancel. Alter means changes. It means the Constituent Assembly was given the power to cancel or to change any law that was made by the British government. The Constituent Assembly duly opened on Monday, the 9th of December in 1946 at 11 a.m. Its prominent members were Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Prominent means leading. Number 1, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Number 2, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Number 3, Maulana Abdul Kalam. Number 4, Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Number 5, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Number 6, Sardar Baldev Singh. Number 7, Frank Anthony. Number 8, Dr. H.P. Modi. Number 9, Vishwanath Das. Number 10, Sarojini Naidu. Number 11, Vijayalakshmi Pandit. These were the two women members of our Constituent Assembly. Which were the two women members? Sarojini Naidu and Vijayalakshmi Pandit were the women members of Constituent Assembly. Out of the count of 300 members in the Constituent Assembly, 9 were the women members of the Constituent Assembly. Framing of the Constitution. By the word framing, we mean constructing of the Constitution or making of the Constitution. The Constituent Assembly has divided the work among the different committees so that it can be done easily. The committees formed by the Constituent Assembly were Drafting Committee, Union Power Committee, Union Constitution Committee, State Committee, Advisory Committee, Provincial Committee, Steering Committee, Rules of Procedure Committee, out of which the Drafting Committee was important. The chairman of the Drafting Committee was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The main work of the Drafting Committee was to scrutinize or to carefully examine the drafts of the India. The Constituent Assembly appointed a number of committees to deal with the different aspects of the Constitution. These were Union Constitution Committee, Union Power Committee, Committee on Minorities, Committee on Fundamental Rights, etc. Here the word comes minorities. It means number of people less than half of the whole. It means total ke half se bhi less. On 29th August 1947, the Constituent Assembly appointed the Drafting Committee of 6 members. When was the Drafting Committee appointed? 29th August 1947. How many members were there in the Drafting Committee? 6 members. Under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who was the chairman of Drafting Committee, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The main purpose of the Drafting Committee was to scrutinize the draft of the Constitution of India. Scrutinize means careful examination. What was the main function or the main purpose of Drafting Committee? The main purpose of the Drafting Committee was to carefully examine the drafts of the Constitution of India. The first draft of the constitution was prepared in October 1947. It contained the salient features of the constitution of about 60 countries, prominent being the USA, UK and Ireland. The views and opinions of the citizen of India were also taken into consideration. When was the drafting committee appointed? August 1947. And when was the first draft prepared? In October 1947. Adoption of the Constitution. The Constitution of India was formally adopted by the Constituent Assembly on 26th November 1949. A motion was passed that the people of India adopted, enacted and gave to themselves the Constitution of Sovereign Democratic Republic of India. By the word sovereign, we mean a country free from the external control. Democratic, it means government of the people, by the people and for the people. And the word republic means no king or queen. The head will be elected by the people of India. Our constitution was framed in less than 3 years. It took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. Less than 3 years. 12 days less than 3 years. On 24 January 1950, it was the last day of the assembly. 1950, the constitution was finally signed by the members of the Constituent Assembly. The constitution came into force on 26 January 1950, which is celebrated as Republic Day of India. After the adoption of constitution, the Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as the first president of independent India. Who was the president? Who was the first president of the independent India? Dr. Rajendra Prasad. When our constitution came into force? 26 January 1950. And when was the constitution adopted? It was 26th November 1949. But there is a gap of 2 months. We can see the two dates in this paragraph. 26th November 1949 and 26 January 1950. Why there is a gap of 2 months to mark the importance of 26 January in the history. As in 1929, the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's father asked for dominion status from the Britishers. By the word dominion status, we mean Indians will work independently but under the signature of the Britishers. But Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose, they were against to the proposal of their father. But they waited for the full 1 year. But the Britishers refused to give the dominion status. So, Jawaharlal Nehru asked for the Purna Swaraj from the Britishers. From that year onwards, Indians celebrated Independence Day on 26 January. But we have Independence Day on 15th August. So, they started celebrating 26 January as a Republic Day. On this day, the Constitution of India came into force. Thank you.